एग्रीकल्चर मार्क डाइवर्सिफिकेशन एंड मार्केट रिस्क। एग्रीकल्चर डाइवर्सिफिकेशन इट रेफर्स टू द री एलोकेशन ऑफ सम ऑफ फार्म प्रोड्यूसिंग रिसोर्सेज इनटू न्यू एक्टिविटीज और क्रॉप्स रिड्यूसिंग मार्केट रिस्क बिकॉज प्राइस ऑफ ऑल क्रॉप्स मे नॉट ड्रॉप एट द सेम टाइम। इफ वन क्रॉप फेचेज लो रेवेन्यू देन द अदर मे फेच हाई। दस डाइवर्सिफिकेशन ऑफ हेल्प स्टेबिलाइजेशन ऑफ फार्म इनकम बाय लोअरिंग द मार्केट रिस्क। डाइवर्सिफिकेशन हैज टू आस्पेक्ट। नाउ व्हाट वी अंडरस्टैंड बाय द डाइवर्सिफिकेशन इज टू ग्रो डिफरेंट क्रॉप्स एट द सेम टाइम बिकॉज इन मार्केट ऑल द क्रॉप्स डू नॉट गेट लोअर प्राइसेस एट द सेम टाइम। एनी वन ऑफ द क्रॉप्स विल गेट अ वेरी हाई प्राइस, देयर मे बी फ्यू विच गेट अ लोअर प्राइस। सो वॉट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू ग्रो मोर देन वन क्रॉप सो दैट वी कैन अर्न अ गुड रेवेन्यू इन 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 मे बी वन और टू क्रॉप्स एंड देयर मे बी अ लोअर रेवेन्यू इन फ्यू क्रॉप्स। सो द प्राइस द इनकम स्टेबिलाइजेशन कैन बी डन इन द एग्रीकल्चर। Now it can be done in different ways like diversification of crop production and diversification of production activities or employment. Now what the diversification of crop production means, it implies production of a diverse variety of crops rather than one specialized crops. It means in place of single cropping we should do multiple cropping, we should grow different crops at the same time. In India, where agriculture is still dominated by subsistence farming, diversification would mean a shift from subsistence farming to commercial farming. Because generally what people do, they do the farming for the subsistence. But we need to change our mindset as well. This would mean the choice of cropping pattern in accordance with the price structure in the market. We need to go with the price structure. The crops which gives us a higher income, we need to focus on those more. It would minimize the market risk arising due to the price fluctuation, and also it would minimize risk of occurring due to failure of monsoon. So this helps in these ways. Now the diversification of production activity or the employment. Diversification of production activities implies a shift from crop farming to other areas of production activity or employment. It means we need to go with the other works as well. We need not to depend on farming only. We need to look for the other sectors as well. What are the other sectors we have? Just like the animal husbandry, the livestock farming, the poultry, the cattle, goat, sheep, these are the important components of livestock in India. Poultry accounts of 42%, cattle 25% and goat sheep nearly 20% share in total livestock in India. So we can go with that all that. A notable feature of crop livestock mix is that as we move from irrigated areas to semi-arid or arid areas, the significance of livestock farming tends to increase while that the crop farming tends to decrease. Because in the irrigated area, we can grow more crops. So we can earn a good amount of money from the crops. But if we talk about the semi-arid or the arid region, here we cannot grow crops throughout the year. So in that case, the livestock helps us a lot. That sustains our income regularly. So the importance of livestock increases in this area. Livestock in India is an important source of employment for the women, because mostly women works with the livestock as they finish their home course, they spend time with the animals at home and they do the work of animal husbandry. It gives about 7 lakh small and marginal farmers employment opportunity in the country. However, livestock sector is not free from problems. What main problems this have is the low productivity owing to backward know-how and deficient veterinary care. We don't have much hospitals and the doctors for animals. Now, so the second way that we can use is the fisheries. Kerala, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, these are the principal states in which the farmers can work in the fisheries as well. The fishing community in India depends almost equally on inland sources and the marine sources. Now, what are the inland sources? These are the sources like lakes, ponds, streams, and the marine sources include seas and the oceans. Together, these sources are called water bodies. So, these water bodies, they are the biggest provider of fish and the livelihood to the fishing community. But fishing community continues to be as one of the most backward community in the country. Because widespread indebtedness of the fishing community makes fishing a vulnerable occupation, it is suggested that the credit facility be provided to the fishing community that breaks the vicious circle of indebtedness. Microfinancing through self-help groups that can help their credit needs, and the fishery technology be upgraded and made available to the fishing community. So all this can be done in this field. Then the other way to earn extra is the horticulture. Horticulture is the agriculture of the fruits, the vegetables, the flowers beside our routine cropping. Nowadays it has been getting substantial increase in the area under horticulture. Lot of people are ready to start the horticulture center to grow the food, fruits, the vegetables and the flowers as well. So now the area under horticulture has increased a lot. Today, India is the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world. We have done a lot of work in this field, especially in the production of mangoes, bananas, coconut, cashew nuts and the spices. High crop productivity led to the golden revolution in horticulture from 1991 to 2012. And that has become a very good source of earning for the rural people in the country. Then the cottage and the household industry, about these we will study in the next video. Thank you.